Shauna.
Okay, how to become a notary in public. Now, I'm going to show you or walk you through the application process of how to become a notary public. Here's the thing, some of the steps differ depending on what state you live in. I live in Texas, so there will be some stuff that you're in your state you might not have to do, and I'll let you know if or if not that is the case. So before you even start to become, or if you want to apply to become a notary, what you have to do is make sure you meet three requirements. First, you're 18. Second, that you live in the state that you're applying to be a notary in. And then last, you've never committed a felony. Okay, so if you got those down packed, let's apply to become a notary. So there's two ways you can apply to become a notary. You can apply directly at the source, which is the Secretary of State, which so is whatever state you live in, Secretary of State notary application. So Google that. Since I live in Texas, I would put Texas Secretary of State notary application, and that application form would be, I think, in Texas 2301. Let me show you. So the application would look something like this. Depending on your state, it would look a little different. And you just put, yeah, your name, your, fill it out like you would any other government form. Your name, your phone number, contact information, social security number, birthday, da 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 da. Then what you would do is also, before you submit it, you would also need to buy something called a $10,000 security bond. Now, I hold you like $10,000. No, you don't have to pay $10,000. The security bond, if you were to buy it on your own, you can Google it. It costs around $50, right? So now that's like $71 right there, just to apply to become a notary directly through the state. And then you would have to take that information and mail that to the Secretary of State. I don't know if you can email it or not, but you can definitely mail it. Now, in other states, there are some states where you don't have to have the security bond, the $10,000 security bond. In Texas, you do. So you can do it directly through them, or you can go through a different party, like a third party who would do all that information for you. You would just buy the packet and it would do it for you. For instance, the NNA, the National Notary Association, will do this for you, right? And you can just buy the bond. It'll come in like in a packet form. Or can you see it on my screen? Yeah, you can see it on my screen. Your Texas notary security bond. You can just buy the bond, the estate application fee, and then application process would be $76. They'll charge you a $5 application processing fee. So you can just do it this way. Easy peasy. Add it to your cart. Buy it. Once you add it to your cart, what will happen? It would take you over here, see right here, and you just buy it, check out, buy it, boom, bada bing, bada boom, and they would file your stuff for you. What would happen is that if you bought this, boom, you bought it, then you would have to come over to go to become a notary. After you bought it or whatever, you'd have to go back to up top, become a notary, scroll down. This is stuff they don't tell you. Scroll down all the way down to additional resources. Then it says online application and bond form. Click that, right? You bought the package, but you actually still have to fill out the application. You click the press application, you fill this out, you fill it all out. Boop, 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 boop. And what will happen, once you fill it out, finish it up, it'll basically, this will basically, it's the same thing. Same thing I showed you. If you go to it to directly SOA, directly through Secretary of State SOS, if you fill that out, it'll just, what it'll do is generate this form with all your information in it. That's all that would do. By filling this notary application out, it would just generate all your information into this form. Once it's in that form, you must print this form out. Yes, you have to be able to print it out. Print it out right now after it's completed, then sign and date it. You hear me? Sign and date it. Now, once you sign and date it, they will give you an email to the NNA, the National Notary Association, will then tell you to email that application to them. See right here, after you've filled it out, email it to them. You can do it by mail, but of course, if you do it by mail, it's going to take longer. But you can email that to them. Simple, easy peasy. just email that to them. And when you email it to them, you will also, after you purchase, remember you had already purchased your package. When you purchase your package, you will get a NNAID number. When you email them, send your NNAID number. When I say send it, like when you draft an email and attach this form that you printed and signed and dated at the bottom, then scanned it back to your computer in computer as a PDF or as a JPEG. You then attach it to your Google Gmail or your Yahoo or whatever internet email that you use. And in the subject box, you just put your NNA number. That way, you just be like, put your name. My name is Shauna. First and last name. And then put your NNA number, attach your form, and email it to them. Then they will send you an email. I will show you the email right now. Then you will after you send that email to them with your attach application and your NNA number, they will send you an email that reads this. Thank you. We received your email. This will take time due to like circumstances, you know, Rona and all that stuff. But they will basically send you confirmation saying, yeah, we got your email. And then that's it. You've done. You applied. After that, what will happen after that is that it's basically a waiting game. Once they send you your commission certificate, you take it to get the oath of office. Basically, you're like, yo, I need to get my certificate, you know, notarized, and I need to take my oath. You can take that to another notary to do that. If you, like, say you, like, bank with Chase. Chase has notaries and they do notarizations for free, so you can go to Chase and do it, or Bank of America, or whoever you with, or you can actually just go pay a notary to do that. And then you take that commission forms after it's been stamped and sealed by another notary. You take it and then upload it to your NNA. Once you log into your NNA account, you take it and they're gonna have a little button to say upload certificate commission or commission certificate. You upload it, and then within like a day or two, you are now a notary. Now, like I said, the process does take about a good 2-3, maybe even 4 weeks, because things have been kind of slow for this whole, you know, Rona situation. But yeah, if you want, you can take courses and stuff to like better get yourself knowledgeable on the whole notary process. But then again, or you can just watch my YouTube videos, because I'm gonna give you all the information you need to know. Either way, thank you, and bye.